Hello everyone. Welcome to my channel, Human Diseases and Genes. Today, I will discuss about Sanfilippo syndrome. Sanfilippo syndrome was also known as Mucopolysaccharidosis III, that is MPS III. It was first described by Dr. Sylvester Sanfilippo and his colleague in 1963. Sanfilippo syndrome is a rare progressive genetic disorder characterized by the accumulation of heparan sulfate, a type of glycosaminoglycan, in the body's tissue due to deficiency in specific enzymes. This condition leads to a range of severe neurological and systemic symptoms. Its prevalence varies slightly based on geographic region and population, and affects approximately 1 in 70,000 to 1 in 1 lakh live births worldwide. Symptoms include progressive cognitive decline, behavior problems, motor dysfunction, severe developmental delay, growth retardation, coarse facial features, hepatosplenomegaly, and skeletal abnormalities. Sanfilippo syndrome is caused by deficiency in one of four specific enzymes involved in the breakdown of heparan sulfate. These enzymes are heparan-N-sulfatase, encoded by the SGSH gene, and its deficiency causes MPS IIIA. Second one is alpha-N-acetylglucosaminidase enzyme, encoded by the NAGLU gene, and its deficiency causes MPS IIIB. Third enzyme is heparan sulfate acetyl coenzyme A, alpha glucosaminidine and acetyl transferase, encoded by the SGSH gene, and its deficiency causes MPS IIIC. Fourth enzyme is N-acetyl glucosamine 6 sulfatase, encoded by the GNS gene, and its deficiency causes MPS IIID. All four subtypes of Sanfilippo syndromes are inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern, meaning an individual must inherit two copies of the mutated gene, one from each parent, to develop the disorder. Due to its rarity and the similarity of symptoms to other neurodegenerative conditions, Sanfilippo syndrome may be underdiagnosed or misdiagnosed. Improved awareness and diagnostic techniques are essential for accurate identification. Diagnosis of Sanfilippo syndrome involves testing for mutations in the genes associated with each subtype. This can be done through DNA sequencing or other genetic assays. Measuring the activity of the relevant enzyme in blood or tissue samples can also help to confirm the diagnosis. This is all about Sanfilippo syndrome. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family to spread awareness. If you have any questions or personal experience or stories with this disease, drop a comment. I would like to hear from you. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of yourself. Thank you. Thank you very much.